ingredients we need. 1 kilogram of chicken cut into pieces or pork cut into cubes. 1 cup vinegar. 1 cup soy sauce. 1 head garlic. 1 onion. 3 to 4 pieces of bay leaves. 1 teaspoon. Whole of peppercorn. 2 tablespoons of cooking oil. 1 cup vinegar. Salt and sugar.
Adobo, a renowned Filipino dish with Spanish roots, is more than just a food. It's a cultural icon loved worldwide for its exquisite blend of flavors. Its savory-sweet flavor profile is a harmonious blend of ingredients that speak to the heart, making it a beloved dish in Filipino cuisine and beyond. So, join us on this gastronomic adventure as we explore the world of adobo, sharing not just a recipe, but a piece of our culture.
To start, marinate the meat by combining it with soy sauce, vinegar, garlic, onion, peppercorns, and bay leaves. In a bowl, make sure to mix everything thoroughly to ensure the meat is evenly coated with the marinade. Let it marinate for at least 30 minutes to 1 hour or even overnight in the refrigerator for a deeper flavor infusion. This marinating process allows the meat to absorb the flavors of the soy sauce, vinegar, and aromatics, resulting in a more flavorful and tender dish.
Second, heat oil in a pan over medium heat. Add the marinated meat and cook until lightly browned, about 5 to 7 minutes.
Next, pour the marinade and water into a cooking pot with the marinated meat. Bring the mixture to a boil over medium-high heat. Then reduce the heat to low. Cover the pot and let the adobo simmer gently for about 30 to 40 minutes or until the meat is tender. Stir the adobo occasionally to prevent sticking and ensure even cooking. The simmering process allows the flavors to melt together while tenderizing the meat, resulting in a deliciously savory and tender dish.
Next, taste the sauce and adjust the seasoning as needed. If it needs more salt, add a small amount at a time, tasting after each addition until it reaches your desired flavor. Similarly, if you prefer a slightly sweet adobo, add sugar gradually, tasting as you go. Keep in mind that the flavors will continue to melt as the adobo sits, so it's best to start with a conservative amount of seasoning and adjust as necessary. Once you're satisfied with the taste, remove the adobo from the heat and serve it hot with the steamed rice.